Hi, good morning everyone. Let's get started with the next topic for this training session, which is on SAP NetWeaver Application Server Java, where we are going to create users using UME engine. So let's get into the system. Here we are in the identity management tab in the NetWeaver portal. Okay, you can see the search criteria is user over here. So basically we can search an existing user, but in this case I am going to create a user to show you guys how do we create a user in SAP Enterprise Portal. Click on create user. Okay, here you can see the information like login ID. Basically this is the logon ID and we can specify the initial password. Let's create a user called test user, and instead of generating a password automatically, we will define a password. So the password that I am defining is test1234, and the mandatory field here in this case is the last name. So we will give the last name only in this case. You can see the other options is disable password. We can disable the password for the user as well. So this is what is available in user creation. So let's save this first. Okay, so we have saved this information. You can see the user is created and the logon ID is test user. So he can log in with this ID. Okay, so that is about the user creation part. Let's modify this user. So what we will do is we will be modifying the users. Basically, we'll modify the user access, and if we click on the modify tab, what we'll do is we'll go to the account information. Okay, here you can see the user account, whether it is locked or not. So this is where you can lock a user. You can unlock a user from here. Then date of validity is there. You can specify from what time to what time it is valid. Then this is user master record. And let's go to the additional information about, say, org units, the position, etc. Okay, so that is how you can charge the users. Next thing is the assigned roles. Okay, so in this case, what can happen is that you can assign the roles from here. Okay, so you are assigning an existing role from this particular screen. So let's search a role and assign it to a user. So this is a search interface for the role. So what I'm doing is I'm searching by name. So this, by this name, there is no such role. So we'll use a wildcard called star admin star. So let's do a search again, and it will show all the roles where we have the admin word in between. So let's select one of the role that we would like to assign, which is administrator. Okay, we assigned the administrator role. Let's save this, and you can see that this user is assigned this particular role. So the test user that we have created is assigned this role. Now here you can see by default these are the two roles which is created for the users, which basically this user is part of these two groups, authenticated user and everyone. They are actually the built-in groups. And in data sources, you can see these are the three data sources that is available. Okay, so let's search another, basically let's search the administrator again. So basically we are searching the word administrator. There is no such word. So what we'll do is we'll use a wildcard, that is star admin star. So basically anything containing admin word will be shown here. So that is how we use a wildcard in a UME search engine. So we'll just click on the modify tab. Now there is no such called admin assigned to this. So now we will search and assign a group which is containing admin. Okay, so this is a group which is containing admin. So let's select this group and assign this group to this user. So let's save this information. So what we have done is that we have assigned this group to this user. Okay, then we have other properties like user mapping for system access. Basically, in case if we are using a backend system for managing this, there will be information about the backend system. So basically it is showing that there is no UME supported landscape deployed. So basically we are not using any other system as the backend system for providing user repository or providing the repository for this particular server. So everything is stored locally in UME database within this portal server itself. Okay, so that is pretty much actually I wanted to cover in this particular training session. Thank you for joining and have a nice day. Bye-bye.